Discussed the discrete. We talked about binomial, the Poisson, the negative binomial, the hypergeometric, geometric, negative binomial. There are so many such distributions which we have talked about. The same way, if my data is more continuous in nature, because most of the discrete ones, what was the modeling was done primarily for number of something, number of claims, to model number of policies, number of claims, number of deaths, wherever it is more to do with the counting kind of stuff, we have used the discrete kind of distribution, because there cannot be 2.3 claims, there cannot be 5.6 deaths, so they are more discrete in nature. But wherever things are more and more continuous in nature, like amount of claims, right, it need not be just one integer or some 100 rounded up. It need not be like that. It can be a 579 rupees 23 paisa, or 30 paisa, 40 paisa, or probably even half, or even if it is a rupee, so many values are possible. It's just not probably when you say numbers, it may lie only between 1 to 100 or very, very few set. Whereas when we are talking about the amount, it can be as big as anything and as variable as possible. All those things we are calling as continuous data. And any distribution we are talking about, the value being from this range to within this range, from this limit to this limit, any particular value possible, we call them as continuous distribution. So in this chapter, we'll look at least 7-8 types of continuous distribution, where the derivation or the background for them may be very much complex. There is a lot of integration that goes into it. There is a lot of there's a lot of mathematics that goes into it. But as far as we are concerned in terms of the exam oriented kind of stuff, a lot of things get boiled down to the usage of tables, right? For at least 4-5 distributions, what happens is, if you use the tables, you can very well get your numbers, and based on that you can solve the numerical. So the focus has to be more from a exam kind of a standpoint, right? So let's start with them. The first of the lot is a uniform distribution, which we had even in the case of discrete also, like all values having equal chance of occurring, rolling a dice 1/6. We said it was a uniform distribution, but that was with discrete data. Only 6 possibilities are there when I roll a dice, and any one of them is possible. So we are talking about 1/6 probability to each of them. Whereas the same thing can happen in continuous data also. Let's say I want to pick up some number between 0 and 1 on a random basis. So almost any value has equal chance of being picked up. 0.001, 0.002, 0.007, whatever it is. So all the values have equal chance of being selected. So whenever I have a scenario, again the same logic, in a particular range, if I am talking of equal chance of being selected for all the values, we call that again as a uniform distribution, but in a continuous form. So, probably if I am talking about, let's say, value lying between A and B. So, if I say x lies between, let's say, 0 to infinity. Any value is possible for x. Now, if I want to find out, what is the chance that it will lie between A and B? Some two other values. So, if I want to find out what is the chance of each element lying between A and B. Each particular element has a possibility of equality across. So if I look at simple, the question that comes out as far as this is concerned is, okay, if I say X lies between 0 and 10. X lies between 0 and 10 and all values have equal chance of occurring. Now tell me, what is the probability that it lies between 3 and 7? Given that X lies between 0 and 10, all values possible, what is the probability that any particular value that is chosen, it is between 3 and 7? One, I know it's a uniform distribution because any value is possible with equal chance is what is mentioned in the question. So, in this case, the simple way that we solve this question is, okay, there are almost 10 units where X can typically take. We are talking about 4 units range, 3 to 7. This is continuous. Any value between 3 and 7. See, it's like this. Let's say heights of people. Right? It is still continuous. But yeah, the typical height could be probably between 3 feet to 7 feet. Or 2 feet to 8 feet. It may not be more than that, right? I mean, between 2 feet and 8 feet, almost all human beings are lying. Or probably 0 feet to 10 feet. Beyond that, no human being is there. Right? So, the total probability is coming out between 0 and 10 itself. Whether it is continuous or discrete, see, the continuous is coming because so many values are possible within that range itself. You cannot count how many values can come between 0 and 10. It can be 0.2, 0.3, 0.23, 0.237, 0.2389. Depending on the scale of measurement you are using, almost every value is possible. That's the reason we are calling it as continuous. It has nothing to do with a range. See, if I say only 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 are the values possible, up to 10, then I will call it discrete. Almost any value possible between 0 and 10, including decimals and all. So, the number of possible values is increasing drastically. That is where we are calling it as continuous. So, if he is saying that X lies between 0 and 10, which means totally any value can come from 0 and 10. Now, the question is, what is the chance that any particular value you have picked up, it lies between 3 and 7 only out of that? So, the simple way that we are looking at is, if I am looking at the range of 0 to 10, right, there are 10 possible units almost. The difference is almost the range is like 10 units. Whereas the required probability range is 4 units, 3 to 7, 4 units. So, the probability is nothing but 4 by 10. A very simple kind of a definition, right? Each item has a probability of, in the denominator, we'll directly take 10, which is nothing but 1 by b minus c. If the question is talking about the allowable limit between 0 and 10, the denominator always talks about 10, the difference between the two. The numerator always talks about what is our favorable range, what range we are typically looking at, and that is what we compute as the probability in this case. So, the only difference between a continuous and discrete case here is, here we are